In this video, I will explain compound lever balance for measuring weights. It is preferred for measuring large weights. Here, two smaller weights, this poise weight and this pan weight, are used to measure a large weight W, which is kept on a platform. It is shown here like this. Usually, this balance is used to measure weight of trucks. Now, it is not always possible to keep the truck exactly at the center. So this balance is designed in such a way that even if truck is not kept at the center, this balance will give the correct result. Now let us prove that position of weight does not affect the measurement of that weight. For that, I have drawn free body diagram of beam scale, this beam scale. Now here, this weight, this poise weight, its moment is balanced by adjustable counterpoise. So initially, moment of this poise weight is adjusted using this adjustable counterpoise. So moment of this and this are same and opposite in the direction, therefore they balance each other. So I have shown only the force, that is, this is a tie rod which is placed here vertical in vertical position. Now there will be one tension in tie rod T, this force vertical downward direction, and there is another force pan weight WY which is acting like this. Now if I take moment about this point, this particular point at the point of support of this beam scale, so you can take that moment, anti-clockwise moment, this is anti-clockwise moment, moment of T will be anti-clockwise and moment of WI will be clockwise about this point. So anti-clockwise moment is equal to clockwise moment, so accordingly you will get T into B, T into perpendicular distance B is equal to WY into A. Now this W is distributed as W1 and W2. If this W is at the center, then W1 and W2 both will be same and equal to W by 2. But if it is not in center, then it will be different. But W1 plus W2 will be equal to W. Now this W1 is transferred to this second platform, and this second platform is supported at this main lever. So now we will draw a free body diagram of this main lever. In this main lever, this lever is attached here with this tie rod. So here one tension will occur, and one force, one load is applied here at this point, and another load is applied at this point. Now this load W2 is a part of this W which is applied here. Now we have to determine value of force occurring here. For that, I will first make free body diagram of this platform 2. So this is platform 2. Now you can see that here two supports are there, one support here and one support here. So there will be two reactions, one here and one here. And one load is applied at this point, which is equal to W1. So I have applied this load W1. Now distance of this W1 are given from here. This distance is F. So distance of W1 from this point is F. And distance of this support from this point is D, here shown. So this I have drawn D. Now you can take moment of all the forces with respect to this point and equate to zero. That means clockwise moment is equal to anti-clockwise moment. So if you take this moment with respect to this point, then W1 its moment will be clockwise and R its moment will be anti-clockwise. So when you use this moment balance method, so you get this R is equal to, that is R into D is equal to W1 into F. So R is equal to W1F divided by D. Now this R is transferred to this main beam. So let's draw free body diagram of this main beam. So I have drawn free body diagram of this main lever. So here one tension T, same which is applied here, because these two will be equal and opposite. In beam scale, we have applied one tension T here in vertical and downward direction. So the same tension we apply here in upward direction T. Now this load at this point we have already calculated, which is equal and opposite. This R is acting vertical upward direction on this platform 2. So R will be vertical downward direction in this main lever. And third one is W2, which is applied at this point. So I have drawn this W2 applied at this point. So there will be one reaction R dash. Now we are going to determine moment of all the forces with respect to this point. So moment of R dash will become zero because it is passing through this point. Now this T is clockwise with respect to this point. When you take a moment of T with respect to this point, then this will be clockwise direction. So this is clockwise, and these two will be anti-clockwise, anti-clockwise. So moment of T must be equal to moment of this force and moment of this force. So that's what I have written here. T into C, perpendicular distance, is equal to, this is the force, W1F divided by D, this is the force, into its distance is E from this point. And similarly, W2 is here, and this distance is H. Now here, I have taken out this H, so I have taken out this H. So this will become W1F divided by D into E divided by H plus W2. Now we can design we can select the value of F, D, E and H in such a way that F by D is equal to H by E, so that multiplication of F divided by D into E divided by H should be 1. So this equation will convert to T into C is equal to H. Now this term become 1 because we have designed in such a way that these two are reciprocal. And so W1 plus W2, now we know that W1 plus W2 is equal to W, so this become W into H. So this tension is independent of, the tension which is applied here is independent of its position. Wherever you want to place this W, you can place in this platform. Ultimately, tension, there will be no effect on the tension which is coming in this tie rod. From first free body diagram, we obtained this relation T into B is equal to WY into A. And from the second free body diagram of this main lever, we obtained T into C is equal to W into H. Now, so T is equal to this tension in tie rod is equal to WH by C. And here T is equal to WY A divided by B. So equate these two T together. So what we will get, that is WY A divided by B. WY A divided by B is equal to WH by C. So this W can be calculated. So this W is equal to A by B into C by H into WY. So this A, C, B and H, these all are constants. So W is directly proportional to WY. So whatever pan weight is there, accordingly you can determine what is this actual W. Now this A, C, B, H, we can take one example. Suppose A into C divided by B into H. So this is my A divided by B, this smaller one, larger one divided by smaller one, into this C, larger one divided by H, this smaller one. So suppose A and C both are larger and B and H are both smaller compared to these two. Now suppose value of this A into C divided by B into H is 100. That means at that particular time, if weight is 1 ton, then that 1 ton weight, if this weight is 1 ton, that 1 ton weight can be adjusted using only by a 10 kg weight. So only 10 kg weight is sufficient to balance a 1 ton load. Accordingly, we can determine whatever weight is there based on the pan weight. Thank you for watching this video.